Good morning, dog breeder friends. I'm Dr. E, and today we are going to talk again about canine herpes virus. In the previous video, you know, we discussed about the clinical signs caused by this pathogen. But today we're going to focus on one that we hear a lot about, infertility. So how does canine herpes virus induce infertility? What are the consequences? So in today's video, we're going to deep dive into this topic.
But what's the big deal with infertility? When I was learning for my exam to become a board certified veterinarian in canine reproduction, I can tell you that in all the books, all the textbooks of canine reproduction and of animal reproduction in general, there was always large paragraphs about herpes. So what's the big deal? What's the big deal with herpes in terms of infertility? I think one of the reasons is that herpes is a major cause of infertility in other species, like in bovine and equine. It is well described. In canine, it is always mentioned. And in fact, this comes from this study. And look at the date, 1979. It's important because remember, canine herpes virus was first isolated in 1964 in the US by the team of Carmichael et al. And following this identification of the virus, few of what we call pathophysiology studies were carried out in different countries. And all those pathophysiology studies, the studies that study the mechanism of the viral infection on an organism, were done in the 70s, beginning of the 80s. Since then, we don't have really new data on canine herpes virus. And I was recently reading a paper on this disease from a team in Belgium, and they were stating that we definitely need more information about the pathophysiology because many of them come from those studies that were performed in the 70s. But in this study, what is interesting is that they decided to study the impact that herpes virus can have in pregnant bitches. So they basically injected a massive amount of canine herpes virus intravenously in pregnant bitches to see how they would react, what would happen following this massive injection of canine herpes virus in their blood. And those bitches had never been exposed before to canine herpes virus infection. So when they were injecting the virus in early gestation, the bitches reacted by having fetal death and mummification. So you could see embryonic resorption in those bitches. It's important to make the difference between embryonic resorption and abortion. When it's an embryonic resorption, typically under ultrasound, you will see that an embryo was an embryo, but you see that the uterus is literally digesting the embryo. It's important because you will see no external clinical sign if you don't do the ultrasounds. So herpes could eventually lead to fetal death and mummification in early gestation. In mid-gestation, it was leading to an abortion. So that's the difference between with embryonic resorption. When you deal with an abortion, there will be expulsion of material, eventually a dead puppy or some brownish or any kind of color vulvar discharge. But you will see external clinical signs when the bitch is infected in mid-gestation. And in late gestation, they typically ended up with premature birth. And obviously, prematurity, as you know, is a very poor prognosis in puppies because very often they didn't secrete what we call the surfactant, a liquid which basically helped them to breathe properly. So in case of premature birth, it's very, very hard to save those puppies. It's very often the neonatal mortality rates are very, very high. So as you can see, based on this study, canine herpes virus can indeed lead to infertility, can indeed lead to pregnancy arrest at any stage of gestation. However, remember one thing, those bitches were infected for the first time during gestation. They had never been exposed to the virus before. So when we put things into perspective, remember that 30 to 100% of bitches, and when we think of the kennel, maybe all kennels, may have been exposed to herpes virus. So fortunately, this is not so common. This is definitely not the most common cause of infertility, but it's important to keep it in mind. today, we all know that the first cause of infertility in canines is from far mistiming of the date of ovulation. So when we see an infertile bitch, we always tell people, first thing to do, make sure you did the timing of ovulation. And then eventually we can carry out more testings, ultrasounds, endoscopy eventually, etc. But herpes can be considered, but it's not a frequent cause of infertility in the bitch. It's essentially a problem if the bitch was contaminated for the first time during gestation, during her gestation,